Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing tutorial. In this particular tutorial, we're going to learn how to put sharpness in an image that is out of focus. It is really very annoying and frustrating going out in the field, taking all these many awesome images, and out of the many, customer insists on that one image that seems not to have focus. In other words, he chooses or she chooses an image that is not really technically competent just because they feel good looking at that particular image. Basically, the client wants it so bad in that you cannot convince them otherwise. Now, in this tutorial, I'm going to share with you the trick I use to bring back focus into some of these images. Many tutorials I see, they tell you to use the sharpness tool, and I see some other tutorials, of course, using several other techniques that seem to be a bit destructive. They tend to distract the image instead because they work on the actual pixels of the images. But this technique I'm going to show you is very, very non-destructive. Basically, you apply sharpness in particular spots where you want them to be applied. If you're a photographer, a hobbyist, or a beginner, you should subscribe to this channel right now, because this is the platform that is going to change your photography game forever. Let me give you a moment to subscribe, to hit the subscribe button. Okay, let's do this. Done. Awesome. If you haven't yet, cool. We are going to sharpen this particular image. When you look at this image here, we have sharpness in the neck area. We have sharpness around here. But when you look in the face basically has that blurry kind of soft focus. It's like the lens had a soft focus filter on top of it. When you look at the edges of the hair, they are really, really sharp. But the parts, the golden section of the whole portrait seems to be out of focus. So what are we going to do? How are we going to do this? If you're going to be doing a frequency separation on such an image or do any skin retouching, I would highly advise you first bring back the focus. If the focus is too bad, if the focus is really, really very, very out, so that you have texture to work with if you're to use the frequency separation technique. If you don't know what the frequency separation technique, I'll leave a link just up there so that you go and see what it is all about. But without further ado, let me take you through these techniques and tricks. So this is what you're going to do. You just come here, we'll duplicate this layer twice. So what we're going to do here, we're going to name this tones, and you're going to name this texture. So here we are going to separate this blurry texture away from the tones. So we're going to have the tones in this layer, and we're going to have the texture in this layer, so that we can work on the texture as the texture alone, right? Okay, let's do this. Let us first unsee this. So you come into here, into filter, you say blur. Yes, I know it is very odd, but you will see it when you'll see why I'm doing this. You say blur and say Gaussian blur. Now we are going to, okay, my neighbors are already talking, and okay, now here is the thing. So we are going to come and we make a very, very light blur, you know, of only and only the textures. So see this, you just come and blur these out just a little bit, just like that. I don't want to take it overboard, because I don't want the textures. Basically, you blur it out slightly in a way that you still see her texture. Don't take it overboard, because we want to only bring back contrast on just those small pores, you know? So let us say, okay, we come into texture layer, we select it, we come into image, you say apply image. And then you come and you subtract the texture off the tones by selecting the tonal layer here. Keep the scale at 2, the offset at 128. Just record whatever you're seeing here, basically. And then you say, okay, So the next thing we are going to do, we are going to say linear light. We blend this into linear light. So what we have done, basically, we have, let me just put this in a group. I'll rename this sharpness. Now, what we have done here, we have basically separated this image into two. Basically, we have put the tones on their own layers and have the textures also on their own layer. So this is what we're going to do now. Now, we're going to come and kill the opacity, select the tonal layer and just kill the opacity of this. See how the sharpness, just focus here. See how the sharpness comes? Okay, let me take it back to zero. If you kill this, see how these parts get back in focus? Now, that is what we want, but we don't want the focus to affect these particular edges. We want only this effect to affect only and only these parts that had a soft focus problem. So what we are going to do, we are going to come here, create a layer mask. How do we create a layer mask? You just select that layer and then you click onto this icon here, just like that. So you're going to press Control I or Command I if you're using a Mac, so that you invert this particular layer. You make sure it won't work if it is this far, if it is just the layer that is selected, but you have to make sure you click into the white icon there, then you press Control I, just like that, so that you invert the whole effect. So we're going to come here and get our brush tool. Here, you make sure that it is white that is on top, opacity, yeah, and flow at 100. Then you come and we begin painting over, just like that. See how we are bringing back the texture? We make sure we're not taking the brush on these other parts that are sharp, like that. So if it is not sharp enough for you to your test, what you can do, you can even multiply the sharpness by duplicating this twice and then having see it even sharpened more. So let us just put this in a group and we just look at the before and after. Now look at this. Let me just zoom it in so that you guys get to see what I'm talking about. We have, that is the before and that is the after. The before and after, basically we've brought back all the powers and all the textures. At least we have now something to work with. Now that's that for today, guys. I don't want to take this tutorial for so long. I just want to keep it short and precise, but today that's that. I hope to see you in my next tutorial. For now, I'll see you and adios.